case you missed it, 2 days ago, I want to repeat Mary Twain Turner. What goal am I talking about? You say, I'm going home. I'm going to go home. Number one, I've got a plan to export more products and outsource fewer jobs. After a decade of decline, this country's now created over 500,000 jobs in the last 2.5 years alone just in manufacturing. That's faster than any time since the 90s. We reinvented the dying auto industry that's back on top of the world. And now you've got a choice. We can keep giving more tax breaks to companies that are shipping jobs overseas, just like the other side is arguing for. Or we can start rewarding companies that open new plants and train new workers and create new jobs right here in Florida. We can help big factories and small businesses double their exports and create 1 million new manufacturing jobs in the next 4 years. You can make that happen. That's part one. Part two, I've got a plan to control more of our own energy. After 30 years of inaction, we raised fuel standards so that by the middle of the next decade, your cars and trucks will go twice as far on the gallon gas. That will save you money. It'll help the environment. We doubled our use of renewable energy, and thousands of Americans now have jobs building wind turbines and long-lasting batteries. Today, the United States of America is less dependent on foreign oil than at any time in nearly 2 decades. Think about that. So we're moving to control our own energy. The other side, they don't have a real plan. So you've got a choice between a plan that wants to just reverse the progress we've made or one that builds on. And let me tell you, I'm like my opponent, I'm not going to let oil companies write this up as energy plan. Or endanger our coastline. Or collect another $4 billion in corporate welfare from our taxpayers. We're not going to let them do that. We've got a better plan. We're going to invest in wind and solar. And power technologies. We're going to help farmers and scientists harness new biofuels to power cars and trucks. We're going to put construction workers back to work, building homes and factories that waste less energy and retrofitting old buildings and homes. We're developing a 100-year supply of natural gas. It's right beneath our feet. If you choose this path, we can cut our imports in half by 2020 and support more than 600,000 jobs in natural gas alone. That's the second part of the plan. You want to hear the third? Third, I've got a plan to give more Americans the chance to gain the skills they need to compete. Education was the gateway to opportunity for me and Michelle. It's a gateway to a middle-class life. For the next time, for the first time in nearly a generation, every state just about has answered our call to raise their standards for teaching and learning. Some of the worst schools in the country have made real gains in math and reading, including here in Florida. Millions of students are paying less for college today, including students here, because we took on a system that was wasting billions of dollars giving student loans money to banks and lenders instead of directly to students. Decide that in the United States of America, no child should have her dreams deferred because of a crowded classroom or a crumbling school. No family should have to set aside a college acceptance letter because they don't have the money. No company should have to look for workers in China because they couldn't find ones with the right skill right here at home. So help me recruit 100,000 math and science teachers in the next 10 years and improve early childhood education. and give 2 million workers the chance to learn skills at that community college that will lead directly to a job.